Hello everyone. In this video, I'm talking about similar shapes and solids. The word similar means the corresponding sides of the two similar shapes are proportional and corresponding angles are equal. The corresponding sides are proportional means, as you see here, the ratio between this side and this side is 2. 10 over 5 is 2. 4 over 2 is also 2. 6 over 3, when you divide, you get also the same 2. And finally, 2 over 1, 2. Okay? This ratio is called the scale factor. So scale factor here is 2, if you want to say 2 over 1, no problem. Okay? It means each side in the bigger shape is double its corresponding side in the smaller shape. Okay? The most important thing here, if you try to calculate the ratio between the corresponding parameters, the parameter of this triangle, the sum of the sides here, and the sum of the sides here, you will get the same ratio. So parameter 1 over parameter 2, the same scale factor, 2 over 4, which is half. Okay? This number 1. So if you want to find parameter of one of them, just write the scale factor. If you multiply by p over 2 here, parameter 2 and parameter 2, it means p1, parameter of one of the figures, is 1/2 or a scale factor times the parameter of the other shape. Okay? Of course, as you see, I wrote here the scale factor 2 over 1, and I wrote it 1 over 2. It doesn't matter. 2 over 1, you start with the bigger shape, and 1 is the smaller shape. 1 over 2, you start with the smaller shape. So, parameter, one of the figures is a scale factor times the parameter of the other shape. And the ratio, this number 1, okay? The ratio now between the areas, if you try to get the ratio between areas of two similar shapes, you will find it scale factor square. For this reason, A1, area of one of the shapes, is a scale factor square times A2. Okay? It's very easy to see that. If you consider now, look at this, square. A square of side 2 centimeters, the area as you see here, look, the area is 4. Consider you double the side length. The length here is 2 centimeters. Consider now I have a length is doubled. It's 4 centimeters. Look what happened. 1. Look at the areas now. What happened to the area? Now consider now this is a square. Sorry, not drawn to scale. Now the side length of this bigger square is double the side length. It's 4. Look. The side here too, the side here consider it's a 4. So the ratio between the areas now, look, scale factor now is 4 over 2, which is 2. But the ratio between areas, area 1 over area 2, now this is 4 times 4, 16, and this is 2 times 2 is 4. Look, the ratio between area is 4 square of this number, 2 squared. For this reason, the area of one of them is a scale factor times the other area. You can see similar things here if you have two similar solids or 3D shapes. The ratio between volume, you can expect now. The ratio between the volume is a scale factor, not square this time, but it's a cube, because you know the volume is calculated by centimeter cube or length times width times height. Okay? It's clear here to investigate that V1 over V2 is a scale factor power 3. For this reason, volume of one of the shapes is a scale factor cubed times the volume of the other shape. So I have three rules now, a summarization now. Look, side one, any side of the first figure is a scale factor times the corresponding side. The same parameter. Parameter one of the shapes is a scale factor also times the parameter of the other shape. The area of one of the shape is a scale factor squared times the area of the other the second shape, and volume for 3D figures here, volume of one of them is a scale factor power 3 volume of the second shape. This is a summarization for the rules I'm using now to solve some questions. Now start, hold your pencil and solve with me these some question, very nice question from Corbett Math. You know, this file you have, I put the link in the video, in the description of the video for this paper if you want to solve it yourself. Question number one. Below are two similar triangles, okay? The area of the triangle A is 20. This area is 20. Consider now, this area is 20 centimeters squared. Okay, work out the area of the other triangle, triangle B. So the area of triangle B is scale factor squared times the area of triangle A. So scale factor, you want to calculate the area of triangle B, start with this side. 14 over 7, the scale factor. Because you are calculating the area of the bigger shape, the scale factor must be bigger than 1. It must be big over small. Squared times the area of this one is 20. That's it. And you just solve it. It's 14 over 7, 2. 2 squared is 4. 4 times 20 gives you 80. Thank you. Very easy. Okay? Write in comments if you have any problem with this one. Below are two similar pentagonal prism. The volume of the prism A is 15. This is volume 1 is 15 centimeter power 3. Work out the volume of the same. Look, scale factor here, if you want to prepare scale factor, is 9 over 3, which is 3. So volume of figure B is scale factor cubed, okay, times the volume of the first one, 15. Thank you, that's it. So 27 times 15, and then multiply, write your answer. Thank you. Very easy, very nice. Yes? Yes. Question number three. You can stop the video now and you solve it yourself. Below are two similar parallelograms. Look, the scale factor here. The area of the parallelogram 28 was the area of the parallelogram 2. Scale factor, start with the side in the figure you want to solve, you want to find it. I mean, don't say scale factor 4 over 6. No, say 6 over 4, which is 3 over 2. So the area of figure B is the area of figure 1, the area of figure A times scale factor square. This area is 28. 28 times 3 squared over 2 squared. Okay. 28 times 9 over 4. You can simplify now, divide by 4, 1 divide by 4 is 7, and 7 times 9, 63. Thank you. Easy, very nice. Don't forget, area of one of shapes is the other area, the area of the other figure times scale factor square. Easy, very easy. Now, you can do now this one yourself. The area of B here is 150 centimeter square. So the area of A, very easy, area of figure A is scale factor, start with the side here. Because you are calculating A, start with scale factor from A. 3 over 15, all squared, times the other area, 150. Thank you, that's it. Very easy. You are solving now this type of question in one step. So it's 1 over 5 squared times 150, 1 over 25 times 150, and you can solve it. Divide by 5, 5, divide by 5, 3, and 0, and 30 over 5 is equal to 6. Very easy, it's very nice. Okay? Next one. Explain why the area of a rectangle increased by a factor of 4 when the side length is doubled. Oh, yeah, you just draw any rectangle, the side length x and y, for example. Now it increased to be a little bit bigger, to be doubled. This, the length. Will double 2y, and the width also will be 2x. The scale factor now, scale factor is equal to 2x over x is doubled, it's 2. Look at the area now. The area, area 1 over area 2, look what happened. Consider that area 1 is the bigger side. So 2x times 2y, the area of the bigger shape, over the area of the original shape xy. So now 4xy divided by xy is equal to 4. For this reason, the area increased by scale factor of 4. Or the area of this one is 4 times the area of this one. Okay, easy, very easy. This one. Shown are two logos that are mathematically similar, not drawn to scale. The area of the first one 20, and I think that asking about the area of the second one. Find the area of the larger one. Very easy. The area of the larger one is a scale factor 20 over 4 squared times the area of the smaller one. Very easy and very nice. 20 divided by 4, 5 squared, 25 times 20 is equal to 500. Nice, very nice. Yes. This one. Shown below are two boxes that are mathematically similar, small and large. The volume of the small box is 500. There is volume equal 500 cubic centimeter. Work out the volume. The volume of the other one is a scale factor 30 over 10 all cubed, don't forget, times the volume of the smaller one. Thank you, that's it. Very easy and very nice. Zero is canceled, 3 cubed is 27, and just multiply 27 by 500, you get the answer. Yes, it's a very nice, very easy. This one. I have two boxes like this. The volume of B is 17. Volume of B, V equals 17, 28. What is the volume of A? Oh, volume of A is volume of B, 17, 28 times the scale factor. You are calculating A, start with the side of A to write the scale factor, 4 over 24 power 3. 17, 28 times 1 over 60 cubed. Use a calculator now to solve it. Thank you, goodbye. Next one. Now you are given the areas of the two figures now. Area 1, area 2 is given. How can you find the corresponding lengths? From the two areas, you will get the scale factor. Okay? Scale factor is equal to 45 over 5. Square root of the area over area. Sorry, square root. No need to write this. Again. Scale factor here is the square root of area 1 over area 2. Always start with this figure. You want to calculate its length to assign or to find the scale factor. So square root of 9 is 3. This is the scale factor. So the x, the corresponding side, time the scale factor. Thank you. Very nice. Very easy. Now you got the answer in 1 minute, less than 1 minute. This one. You have the two volumes. So the scale factor equal cube root of the first volume over the second volume. Very nice. The cube root of 8 is equal to 2. So you want to find y. Y equal the length of the corresponding height time scale factor. Thank you. I got the answer now. Yes, I'm sorry, but it's not 2. 20 times 2 is 40. Yeah. I look so happy today. I don't know why. No problem. Prism A and prism B are mathematically similar, not drawn to scale. So this 25 square centimeter, and here I don't know. Prism A has a cross-sectional area of 25 square centimeter. Work out the volume of prism B. The volume of prism B. The volume, look, I have here this cross-section area and I have the height. So I can find the volume one. Consider now volume figure A now. Volume of figure A is a cross-section area. Yes? Cross-section area times height. So the smaller solid here is the volume 250 centimeter power 3 or cubic centimeter. So sure, the volume of the B figure is a scale factor, which is 24 over 8, yes, which is 3 power 3 times the volume of the first shape that you got it now. Yes. So 27 times 250. Now use your calculator and write your answer. Okay. Let's finish my video today with this question. Okay, a swimming pool has a surface area 300 meter square. The swimming pool is a prism of a depth of 110 centimeter. Look, this is meter square, this is centimeter. Be careful, different units. Work out the volume of the swimming pool in cubic meters. First of all, go to the depth of water, make it 1.1 meter. Okay, divide by 100. Now, the volume of this swimming pool is a surface area, 300 meter square times 1.1 meter gives you meter cube. That's really 30 times 11, which is 0.33, 330 cubic meter. A scale model of the swimming pool is made. The depth of the model swimming pool is 5.5 centimeter. Look. Find the surface area of the model. First of all, you have to compare the scale factor now. The scale factor now is the depth of water here, 5.5 centimeter over 110 centimeter, which is 55 over 1100, which is divide by 11, 5 divide by 11, 1. So it's a 5 over 100, it means 1 over 20 after simplification. This is a scale factor now between the real swimming pool and the model one. It means the 1 centimeter in the model is a corresponding length 20 centimeter in the real swimming pool. The question now, find the surface area of the model swimming pool. The surface area, calculate the surface area here, okay? But in meter square. The surface area now in the model is scale factor, here in the model, scale factor square, 1 over 20 squared, times the surface area of the real swimming pool, 300 meter square, 300. As you see, I got 1 over 20 from a centimeter over centimeter. It doesn't matter if you change it meter to meter, you'll give you the same 1 over 20 as a scale factor because you multiply both numerator and denominator by 100, will not affect the final answer for the value of scale factor. So the answer is 1 over 400. Okay? Yeah, 20 times 20 times 300 gives you 3 over 4 cubic. Square meter, because really 300, this number is square meter. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Goodbye. Bye.